Puppy Pow Pow and Grandma find the Halloween costume. One Sunday morning, Puppy Pow Pow was watching ducks from the deck with her favorite ducky toy called Gaga. Through binoculars, she saw the ducks hanging around the lake behind her house.
Quack, quack, she said in Gaga's ducky voice. The one with the green head is a mallard. The one with a red, bumpy face is a muscovy. The one with a white bill and black feather must be a coot, not a duck, technically.
Pow Pow loved watching ducks more than anyone in town. Pow Pow, Mom called out, Halloween is coming next week. Why don't you buy a new costume? There's a pop-up Halloween store near the market. I'm sure Grandma would love to see you in your costume. The Halloween store was open every fall. Pow Pow had never shopped there alone.
Can I shop all by myself? And what kind of costume should I get?
She asked Gaga. Dad came in and handed Pow Pow some coins.
Can you come with me, Daddy?
Pow Pow pulled at his shirt as he turned to leave.
I have to watch the doggies' ball game,
Dad said.
You are a sharp and heroic little puppy. You'll be fine.
He patted Pow Pow's head. Pow Pow put Gaga and the coins in her backpack and went to the Halloween store. She was greeted by a skeleton standing at the entrance. The inside was dark, and spiderwebs were hanging from the ceiling. Hundreds of costumes were displayed here and there.
So many choices. Which one should I get?
She asked Gaga.
Quack, quack. What about that princess costume?
Pow Pow imagined herself in the costume and shook her head.
Nah, that's not what I want.
Quack, quack. What about that witch costume?
Pow Pow imagined herself in the costume and shook her head.
Nah, that's not what I want.
Quack, quack! What about those costumes?
Pow Pow moved closer to a collection of costumes in the far back of the store. The collection was called The Beast. A cow and a pig just picked up theirs.
Wow, I can look like a tough buffalo,
said the cow.
I can look like a fearless boar,
said the pig. They were both excited and skipped away to the cashier. Pow Pow scanned the beast collection and found a wolf costume. The wolf on the package looked so fierce.
What do you think, Gaga?
Quack, quack. You can really scare villagers by wearing that. They will give you more candies. You can share the candies with Grandma.
Pow Pow picked the wolf costume, went to the cashier, and took out the coins from her backpack. With a sparkle in her eyes, she said,
Can I buy this?
Is that all you have?
A baboon at the cashier frowned. Pow Pow nodded, her cheeks trembling. The baboon thought for a moment, then said,
Okay, you seem to be a good puppy. Take this one.
He handed Pow Pow another bag of the same wolf costume from underneath the counter.
A father of a little puppy just returned it. Maybe the size didn't fit, but on you, it should look fine. If you promise not to return it, I can offer a special half-price discount. That will add up to all of your coins.
Pow Pow took the deal anyway and hurried to Grandma's house. She talked to Gaga as she ran.
Uh-oh, was the discount too good to be true?
Quack, quack, no. The baboon said the size didn't fit. You're very lucky to get it, just because someone returned it.
Pow Pow arrived at Grandma's house and found her carving a jack-o'-lantern in the backyard. The little puppy ran over and showed Grandma the costume bag.
Look, Grandma, I'm going to be the Beast for Halloween. Oh, my dear, that sounds is amazing. I can't wait to see you in the costume,
Grandma said. Pow Pow and Grandma went into the house. Pow Pow pulled out the costume and tried it on.
How do I look, Grandma?
Grandma laughed.
Ha ha, you look so cute.
Cute?
Pow Pow looked in the mirror. The head part of the wolf costume looked like a little cub. It was far from the wolf beast pictured on the package. She blushed and hung her head.
Quack, quack. That must be the reason it was returned.
Poor Poppy.
Grandma smiled.
It's okay. You can return it.
But I got a special discount for not returning it,
said Pow Pow.
I'll look so silly if I wear this. It's like a puppy putting on a puppy costume. I won't scare any of the villagers. And I won't get a lot of candies to share with you, Grandma.
She murmured.
Ah, you're so sweet,
Grandma said.
Well, you don't have to scare them to get treats. They'll give you the candies whatever you wear.
I don't have to scare them?
No, not at all. So ask yourself, what do you want to be like for real?
Pow Pow mused for a while, holding Gaga in her paws. Then she snapped her claws.
I know what my favorite is!
Grandma nodded and took Pow Pow to the kitchen.
Let's make a homemade duck mask. First, blow up a balloon to the size of your head. Dip pieces of used paper into multi-purpose glue and paste the paper around the balloon. Wrap the head with white paper with glue. Use scissors as needed to fit the paper to the sphere shape. Also, make a cone with another piece of paper and squeeze it a little bit so it looks like a duck bill. Then attach it to the head. When it's dry, cut a large hole to fit in your head and cut two small holes near the bottom of the bill to see from inside. Paint the head brown and the bill orange. Once the paint is dry, it's done!
Pow Pow put on the mask and wrapped a brown blanket around her.
Quack, quack! I'm a mallard hen!
On Halloween night, Pow Pow and Grandma visited Grandma's neighbors together.
Trick or treat!
Pow Pow called out in the homemade duck mask. The neighbors loved the costume and gave her a generous amount of candy.
Ah, we made a good team,
said Grandma.
We collected so many treats. They can last until the next Halloween, right?
She tried to high-five Pow Pow.
Not so fast, Grandma. Guess what is the best treat for us?
Pow Pow asked.
Ah, I forgot all about them. Let's do it,
Grandma said. Pow Pow and Grandma arrived at Black Sheep's waffle stand near the farm. It was still open for Halloween night. They sneaked over to the stand, hid below the counter, and then jumped up.
Trick or treat!
Oh my! Black Sheep said with her eyes wide open. Welcome back, Grandma and Puppy.
Can we have two waffles, please?
Asked Pow Pow. Well, tonight is Halloween, and you look so great in your costume. So they're on me, Black Sheep replied.
You don't have to do that,
said Grandma.
It's okay, Black Sheep said, shaking her head. I just made pumpkin spice waffles. Why don't you try them?
Pow Pow and Grandma enjoyed their special Halloween waffles.
Mmm!
The cinnamon and nutmeg add a great kick to the pumpkin flavor,
Grandma said. Pow Pow nodded.
Mmm! The best pumpkin waffle ever!
They looked at each other and said,
"This is fun, isn't it?"
It was time for Pow Pow to go home. Mom and Dad were waiting at Grandma's house to pick her up. But first, Pow Pow had something to say.
"Thank you, Grandma. You saved my Halloween."
Grandma smiled.
"You saved mine, too. I was so happy to spend the evening with you. But I wasted the coins for that lame costume."
Pow Pow was holding back tears. Grandma held Pow Pow's paws.
"You didn't waste anything."
Pow Pow looked up at Grandma.
"Really?" "Yes, you learned a good lesson. You can be whatever you want to be and still can be happy. It's not about how you look, but how you feel."
"What about you?"
Pow Pow asked.
"Me?"
Grandma cocked her head.
"What do you want to be?"
Pow Pow whispered. Grandma replied with tears in her eyes.
"I want to be the best grandma for you. That's all I want."
Pow Pow waved goodbye to Grandma and headed home with Mom and Dad.
"How do you feel, Gaga?"
she asked the ducky in her backpack.
"Quack, quack. You look like my mom tonight. Can't wait for the next Halloween."
Pow Pow looked back. Grandma was still there, waving her paw in the far distance.
"You're already my best grandma!"